Hello everyone, welcome to the new session of this unit, that is type of a semiconductors. In the last lecture we have discussed about the semiconducting properties. Just we have to be revise these parts. The semiconductor acts like an insulator at 0 Kelvin. On increasing the temperature, it works as a conductor. Due to their exceptional electrical properties, the semiconductors can be modified by doping to make the semiconductor devices suitable for energy conversion, switches, and amplifiers. The lesser power losses makes semiconducting material advantageous to various applications. The semiconductors are smaller in size and possess less weight as well. Their resistivity is higher than conductors but lesser than the insulators. The resistance of semiconducting material decreases with the increase in temperature and vice versa. So all we know about that, the semiconductors are classified according to its purest form of material in two different sections or in two different types. The first one is nothing but the intrinsic semiconductor, whereas another one should be called as extrinsic semiconductor. The intrinsic semiconductor have the purest form of germanium or silicon, whereas the extrinsic semiconductor is having the impurity added to a purest form. Because of that, it again has been classified into two types. The first one is N-type semiconductor and another one that is P-type semiconductor. The N-type semiconductor having pentavalent impurity added to the semiconducting material, whereas in a P-type of a material, the trivalent impurity is to be added to the semiconducting material. So let's start to discuss these classifications in detail. The first one, that is nothing but the intrinsic semiconductor. Let us assume that the atomic structure of an particular material or semiconducting material. Let us, over here we can take an example of a silicon. The silicon structure is having the atomic covalent bonding is shown over here. When the pink color circle, it should be shows you the nucleus, whereas the blue dot is nothing but the hole, and the yellow dot should be defined as an electron. The green arrow should be defines the direction of electron movement, and the yellow arrow should be defines direction of hole movement. Now in a particular atomic structure, when the covalent bond is between the two atoms or two atomic structures is with the free electrons, considering the aligning of one electron each to produce a covalent bond. These are the covalent bonds made up of this silicon material among itself. But when an external energy it should be applied on that semiconducting material, the atomic structure it should be breaks its outermost orbit, and this covalent bond gets broken. Now, this broken electron is to be moved over here. This broken electron is to be moved over here. And now, over here, the direction of that whole movement should be as like this. Because of that, in the absence of that electrical field, only these two electrons or holes is to be present in this structure. But when an electrical field should be applied in this type of material, what will happen? This electron, it should be moves towards an conduction band, and because of that, the movement of this electron, it should be creates an current flowing mechanism or conduction mechanism in that semiconducting material. Whereas the whole movement present over here is to be moved towards an atom or towards an next atom. So in this type of a structure, the intrinsic type of semiconductor, it should be creates the movement along with electrons and holes according to the electrical field it should be applied into that particular material. The current flow in the semiconducting materials takes place due to the two types of carriers, namely electrons in a conduction band and the holes, which are positively charged carriers in the valence bands. As stated earlier, a hole is nothing else but the vacancy of an electron in the valence band. A hole has a positive charge which is exactly equal to the charge on an electron. A hole can move in the valence band and therefore can take the part in a conduction process as shown in figure. An intrinsic type of semiconducting material is made to be very purely chemically. It is made up of only a single type of element, that is nothing but germanium, denoted as Ge, and silicon, denoted as an Si, are the most common type of intrinsic semiconductor elements. They have four valence electrons, that should be called as a tetravalent. They are bound to the atom by covalent bond at absolute zero temperature. When the temperature rises due to collisions, few electrons are unbounded and becomes free to move through the lattice, thus creating an absence in its original position should create some holes. These free electrons and holes contribute to the conduction of electricity in the semiconductor. The negative and positive charge carriers are equal in numbers. The thermal energy is capable of ionizing a few atoms in the lattice, and hence their conductivity is less. At absolute zero Kelvin temperature, the semiconductor should be perform different properties. Okay, so we will discuss at the lattice of pure silicon semiconductor, it behaves differently at different temperatures. In this session, we are going to discuss there are two different types of temperatures we have to be applied on that semiconducting material. Due to that, the semiconductor properties are showing the different properties. First one, at absolute zero Kelvin temperature, the covalent bonds are very strong and there are no any free electrons available. Due to that, the semiconductor behaves as a perfect insulator. At absolute zero Kelvin temperature, the semiconductor behaves as a perfect insulator. Whereas, at above absolute temperature, with the increase in a temperature, few valence electrons jumps into the conduction band and hence it behaves like a poor conductor. So, above absolute temperature, the semiconducting material behaves as a poor conductor. So this is the energy band diagram of intrinsic semiconductor, where the figure A shows the intrinsic semiconductor at temperature is equal to 0 Kelvin behaves like an insulator, because this energy band diagram, the conduction band and valence band should be having the highest band gap energy, that should be nothing but Eg. Due to that, the electrons are unable to conduct from one band to another band, and due to that, the material should be behaves like an insulator. But as shown in figure B, the temperature, it should be goes on increasing level, the energy or the band gap energy between the two bonds are going to disperse and some amount of electron hole pairs are dispersed through one band to the another band, that is valence to conduction band, and due to that, the thermally generated electron hole pairs should be carrying a small amount of current. It should be shows in figure B. So the intrinsic semiconductor is having the small amount of current due to the electron hole pairs, as the movement of these two pairs is to be carried out when the temperature is should be applied on that semiconducting material. So this is how the intrinsic semiconductor should be works. In intrinsic semiconductors, current flows due to the motion of free electrons as well as holes. The total current is the sum of electron current, that is IE, due to the thermally generated electrons and the holes, that is hole current IH. So that the total current I is nothing but IE, that is electron current, plus IH, that is nothing but hole current. For an intrinsic semiconductor at finite temperature, the probability of electrons to exist in conduction band decreases exponentially with increasing band gap, that is Eg. So with the help of this formula, we can calculate that band gap energy, that is nothing but N is equal to N0 e raised to minus Eg divided by 2 kBT, that is nothing but Kelvin temperature, where Eg is nothing but the energy band gap and kB is equal to Boltzmann constant. So this is how we can find out the band gap energy of a particular semiconducting material with the help of this equation. The next part of that semiconducting material is the another classification which is generally defines, that is extrinsic semiconductor. Now the conductivity of semiconductors can be greatly improved by introducing a small number of suitable replacement atoms called as impurities. The process of adding impurity atoms to the pure semiconductor is called as a doping. Usually only one atom in 10 raised to 7 is replaced by a dopant atom in the doped semiconductor. An extrinsic semiconductor can be further classified into N-type semiconductor and P-type of semiconductor. If small amount of trivalent or pentavalent atoms are added to the intrinsic silicon or germanium, then we get a doped, impure or extrinsic semiconductor. The impurity is nothing but some other material. The process of adding impurities is called as a doping, and the material being added is called as a dopant. Due to doping, the conductivity of the semiconductors increases. Thus, the extrinsic semiconductor have a better conductivity than the intrinsic semiconductor. Therefore, they are used in manufacturing of all electronic components such as diodes, transistors, etc. The extrinsic semiconductors are having the two types, that is N-type of semiconductor and P-type of semiconductor. So over here we can define or we can differentiate the two types of semiconducting materials, that is N-type of extrinsic material and P-type of extrinsic semiconducting material. So over here the N-type of semiconducting material is having the pentavalent impurity it should be added to a silicon material. Now this is the silicon material should be there, and over here the pentavalent material it should be added to a silicon material. Now what will be happens in the silicon material, the pentavalent impurity is having a 5 electrons in the outermost orbit. Therefore, each of one electron it should be added to adjacent atom structure, so it should be creates an covalent bond. In these four types of atoms, but one donor impurity, that is nothing but the electron, it should be present in this type of material, because this material, that is impurity material, is having the 5 electrons in its outermost orbit. The each of one it should be added to this 4 atoms, but the one should be remaining. And that remaining electron is nothing but the donor impurity contributes the free electrons. It should be having the free electrons in its own structure. That type of material should be called as N type of material. That should be types of material should be called as N type of material. Whereas in the P type of material, the same type of concept it is to be used, but over here the tetravalent impurity should be added to a particular material, means this part should include the outermost orbit is only 3. So the each one of that atom should be takes an electron for covalent bond, but over here the one electron is to be missing or it should be required to complete the bonding between these two atoms. The due to their tetravalent impurity, only three atoms are satisfied. The fourth one remains as it is. And henceforth, if the material behaves this type of structure, should be called as the P type of material. In the N type of semiconductor, the semiconductor's materials are mainly due to the electrons. The semiconductor material is entirely neutral. The total current I is nothing but IH, and NH is greater than NE. Majority is nothing but electrons, and minority is nothing but the holes. When a pure semiconductor in bracket silicon or germanium is doped pentavalent impurity, then 4 electrons out of 5 valence electrons bonds with the 4 electrons of germanium or silicon. The 5th electron of the dopant is set free. Thus, the impurity atom donates a free electron for the conduction in the lattice and is called a donor. Since the number of free electrons increases by the addition of an impurity, the negative charge carriers increase. Hence, it is called as N-type of semiconductor. The crystal as a whole is neutral, but the donor atom becomes an immobile position ion. As conduction is due to a large number of free electrons, the electrons in the N-type of semiconductor are majority carriers and holes are nothing but the minority carriers. In the p-type of semiconductor, the p-type of semiconductor is mainly due to the holes. It is entirely neutral. It has also the formula of total current is nothing but the current through electrons and current through NH is greater than when a pure semiconductor is doped with a trivalent impurity, then the 3 valence electrons of impurity bonds with 3 of the 4 valence electrons of the semiconductor. This leaves an absence of electron hole in the impurity. These impurity atoms, which are ready to accept bonded electrons, are called acceptors. With the increase in the number of impurities, holes, that is nothing but the positive charge carriers, are increased. Hence, it is called as a p-type of a semiconductor. Crystal as a whole is a neutral, but the accept becomes an crystal as a whole is a neutral, but the acceptors become an immobile negative ion. As conduction is due to a large number of holes, the mobiles in the p-type of semiconductor are majority carriers and electrons are minority carriers. Over here we can just look out the difference between intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor. The intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor, the differentiation points are: the first one is intrinsic semiconductors are the purest form of semiconductor, whereas an extrinsic semiconductor it having some of impure semiconducting materials. In intrinsic semiconductor, the density of electrons is equal to the density of holes, whereas the density of electrons is not equal to the density of holes in extrinsic semiconductor. Then the third point, electrical conductivity is low. In the intrinsic semiconductor, electricity is low, and in extrinsic semiconductor, the electrical conductivity is high. In the fourth one, dependence on temperatures, the intrinsic semiconductor should be works, and the dependent on temperature as well as the amount of impurity, the extrinsic semiconductor should be works. In a semiconductor, no impurities should be added, and in extrinsic semiconductor, trivalent impurity or pentavalent impurity it should be added to a semiconducting material. These are some applications of a semiconductor. Temperature sensors are made up with semiconducting devices. They are used in 3D printing machines, used in microchips, self-driving cars, used in calculators, solar plates, computers, and other electronic devices. Then transistor or MOSFET used as a switch in electrical circuit are manufactured through semiconductors. Some of that important advantages of semiconductors are mentioned over here. They are highly portable due to the smaller sizes. They required less input power. The semiconductor devices are shockproof. Fourth one, they have a longer lifespan. And the last one, that is, they are noise free while operating. So up to this part we have ended the third session of this unit. If you have any problem, just message me or call me on my personal number. Okay, thank you very much.